Hello, it's Bloody Otaku here once again with the March 2017 Humble Monthly Unboxing. Which, well, I'm gonna try and do something a bit different. And by a bit different, I mean try and add some content of me actually playing most, if not all, of the games. Now, I have already, as there was last month, they have actually already shown in the email what the games are. So, as of just a few minutes ago, I did the usual calculations, and the total savings, any total cost, would be £116.93. And the only good thing is that none of the games are currently on discount. So, that's nice. Yeah, so, without further ado, let's move in and, yeah. Yeah. So, now that's weird, it's not giving me any redeem for Total War Warhammer. Now that is odd. Alright, but the other codes are Polybridge, Space Run Galaxy, 1 Beast Pirate Warriors, Arrive, Flat Heroes, and Morph Blade. The humble indie original is Urnog. Yeah, and just one minute, I'm gonna have a look at the for some unknown reason it's not showing here to allow me to redeem the key. Yeah, and the early unlock for next month is The Witness, which is actually a $29.99 game. Because it's showing here, click to redeem on Steam. And don't bother trying to get any of the other keys from this pack, from this lot. I've already used them. Alright, Polybridge. It's pretty much a construction one. As I say, brief reading. Space Run Galaxy. It's actually a sequel to the original Space Run. One Piece Pirate Warriors 3. Can't say a lot about One Piece. Never really watched it. Not really interested in it. But I mean, some of this stuff is, in my brief look through, does interest me. But well, unfortunately, there might be an issue with Total War Warhammer, because I just double checked the minimum requirements and it requires a 3 GHz dual core processor. The thing is that it states core 2 duo. So which means it would go back to socket 775. However, I've got a more modern processor, even though it is a 2.7, there might be a chance that it would actually work, but I'm not actually going to risk trying to run the game and capture video. So, yeah, I am going to try. Yes, it says Flat Heroes, Morph Blade, One Piece Pirate Warriors 3, Polybridge Drive, Sauron Galaxy, Total War, Warhammer 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Yep. Yeah, so, right, so Morphblade runs 31, 32 bits, but Rive is actually a 64 bit. Right, well, what I'm going to do is stop this, swap software to OBS Studio, and hopefully when we reconvene, I will have one of the games running. Right, and we are back, hopefully recording with the first I decided to boot up, Flat Heroes. So, as long as the sound is actually working. Waves, battle, exit. Okay, let's go waves and world one. Right. So you have to avoid the. Hold down the space bar. Right. Okay. Right. So, spacebar to jump. And clear. Easy and rather fun. Right. Right. So. Okay. Let's try this again. We go leap, leap, and. Yes! Okay. And, alright, we are sitting here. Right. Okay, and leap over. Butterfingers! And we are clear! Finally. Right, I do not want to run this. Right, and okay, let's try this again and jump. Okay, one, two, one, two. Yep. Okay, right, where are we sitting now? And, alright. Alright! Ah! Okay, so we go up, up. And come here. Yep. Oh, I just love this, even though my hand's about as coordinated as Kaka. Ah! Right. So, ah, yes, the old two-handed trick. Let's try this again. Right. Okay. Yep, yep, yep. Go on. And we are done with that one. Right. Right. Ah, right. So we stay here. Ah. Right. So we stay here. Okay. Right. So right, so first up. Ah, right. Okay, right. Ah. Right, so bit better on the finger coordination. Okay. Once more. Yep. So I'm going to call it an end here, exit out, and go to the next game. Okay, let's try One Piece. I have a bad feeling about this.
Kaつて, この世の全てを手に入れた男.
Yes, skip the event. Yep.
隠して
ドロナゾロのひどい。1ヶ月決めたぞ。その時はぞ。 Okay.
ゾロ、仲間に誘うぞ。おい、ここから先は立ち入り禁止だぞ。行けよ、俺はゾロに会うんだ。ゾロのゾロの仲間か。こいつを捕まえろ。やれるもんならやってみろ。
Yep. 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 Yep Okay. Okay. So let's move and... Okay. Okay. Is where I should be heading. Right. Door here. Okay. Aha. Okay. Treasure event. Okay, let's just end this and get on to the next one. Right, we are now in Polybridge. Right. Okay. By connecting two static joints. Alright. Okay. Ah! Right, so this is just pretty much the, Yep. Right, so... Okay, and yep, we are done. Build a road by collecting two static joints. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have to build for two cars. Right, and build static truck. And done. Time to build a drawbridge. Okay, so that is, the car is now going across, the bridge has now gone up, and the ship has safely gone through, and I can guess this little geezer in his scooter is next over. And we are done. Right, next. Yeah. Okay. So, we undo. And... hey! He's through! You have completed the tutorial. Just a few more things to keep in mind. Our comprehensive manual is available from the top left menu. You can replay the tutorial at any time from the level selector screen. If you get stuck, you can skip this level and try another. But don't forget to save! Okay. Yep. Yep. And we... yep, and this is Polybridge. As I actually probably just mentioned. So, let's end this recording and get to the next one. Right. And we now have Riven. I said, press the any key. Where's the any key? I wish it had stopped doing this garbage. Press the any key. Video resolution, right. Full screen on. Right, so. Campaign, regular mode, normal.
Whoa! That's some kind of way to wake up.
Yeah.
Why is this screen not working? Ha! A dragon punch fixes everything.
Yep.
Alright, we're not doing too bad. Fuel's kind of low though. Let's see what's going on around me. Well, I'm looking good, but that's not what I wanted to see. Damn, that's a lot of space rock.
Switching to shmup mode.
In style. Put on some classic game music. And do this.
Ah! Ooh! Yes! Right, so move the controls, fire with the mouse. Come on, move out of my way, missiles. Okay.
I'll hack the dingus with my special beam.
Okay.
I'm in. Ooh, it's deeper than I thought. Station here. Almost out of kerosene. I guess I can't go here without protection. It's a warp system. Outdated model, though. Seems like I just activated it. I'll record its coordinates.
Right.
Are these crates what I think they are? Wow, there's an upgrade machine here.
Okay. Yep. $800. Yep, kill stream bonus, loot bonus, time bonus. Main menu has opened up. Missions let you replay parts of the game and improve your high score. Challenges has something new for every day in bronze, silver, and gold variations. Battle arenas offers endless fighting. Just how long can you survive?
Let's see what this does.
Okay. So, That's this one done. So let's get on to, well, I think will be the final item in today's itinerary. Yep, stupid me. I actually forgot about Morphblade. Okay. Right, this is like some kind of... Right. Yeah, this is... Right. Okay. Yes. So it is basically a kind of capture everything. So, yeah. Right, well, now... Let's get on to the final item in today's itinerary. Though I can't really trust recording Total War Warhammer, especially with this computer. And now we're in the final run for Space Run Galaxy. Oh. Right. Right, let's do this. Traveling to the Vera system. I think one thing I'll need to do first is... turn the volume down on the headphones so I can at least hear myself talk.
Greetings, potential space runner. I'm Captain Buckman. Back in the day, maybe 20 years ago, when this sector was new, I was a space runner. Actually, not to brag, but I was the space runner. Yep, if anybody needed anything delivered from one planet to another, I was the man to do it. Now, I'm starting my own company of space runners. Your exploits have come to my attention. I want you to work for me. Yes, you should be honored. I want to hire you to fly planet to planet making valuable deliveries all over the known worlds. What's in it for you? Well, I'll tell you. If adventure, fame, the thrill of exploring new worlds and all that jazz isn't enough for you, I'll also make sure you get paid top credits. Plus, during my days as the premier space runner in the galaxy, I made a lot of connections. People, important people, come to me with jobs, and I can assign those jobs to you.
Yeah, so this is actually
Captain,
the sequel.
We have an incoming call from a Mr. Buckman.
Yeah.
He claims it's a lucrative offer for you. Since it sounds interesting, I am putting him through to you.
Hey, rookie.
Mr. Man, I would appreciate it if you would address my captain with more respect.
The E-36 model. Back in the day, I used to run around space with the Atom 12 model. You are much easier on the eyes and the mind. See what I mean?
Mr. Man, please get to the point. So, you want my captain and I?
Yep. You're certainly way more...
Still sitting right here. Still can hear everything you say.
My HQ is in the middle of a quaint little debris field on the planet Gaius. You come find me and I'll set you up with your first job. You'll be very lucrative. All your captain and you need to do is be fast and survive.
Your offer is quite interesting,
okay,
to say the least. What do you think, Captain? Okay, Mr. Buck, you have a deal. Captain, before our arrival, I would like to make sure that you understand. You can see our ship in the center of the screen. It is composed of hexagonal pieces linked together. It seems simple, but it is quite versatile. You can also see our command bridge. It is where we are standing right now, and it's the core of our ship. Whatever happens, don't let anything bad happen to this bridge. We're both way too young to die. You can change the view by moving the mouse cursor to an edge of the screen. The view will slide in that direction. To center the view on your ship if it is off screen, click on the portrait icon. Or if you want fast and easy, you can also press the space key at any time to... Very well. Buckman is waiting for us at his headquarters. I suggest you hurry now to impress him. Speed is an important part of our job. The only way to move faster is to build thrusters. The utility construction section is now activated. Now, select the space thrust. You can now place your new thruster on your ship by clicking on a valid location. Thrusters must always be placed in front of an empty space.
Quite an interesting choice.
Now on to some fun stuff. As you are probably aware, space is dangerous. The offensive construction section is now active. Now, select the laser cannon. Laser cannons can be oriented before placing them on ship. Use the mouse wheel to rotate the cannon in the direction you want. Then, click on a valid empty spot on the ship to build it.
Ready to shoot!
All constructions you build during a run cost hex nuts, as nothing in this world is free. You can see at the bottom of the screen your current hex nuts balance. When you blast enemies out of the sky, they usually drop some hex nuts in space. To collect them, simply move your mouse cursor on the floating hex nuts. Resource you have to manage during runs is focus. Almost every construction you build on your ship has a special ability requiring focus to be activated. When you face more resistant enemies, you can use the laser cannon's special ability for a little extra kick. To do so, select a laser cannon on the ship, then activate the manual shot ability. Aim in the direction you want using the mouse, then click to launch a powerful shot. Then smile as you watch the bad guy taking a beating. Remember, when you use special abilities, it spends focus. Thrusters will regenerate this focus over time, but they also give you immediate focus when you build a new one. To get more focus, simply build more thrusters on your ship. The math is simple. More thrust equals more focus. Note there is a limited amount of each piece of equipment that you can build during a run. But don't fret, they will all be refilled at the beginning of a new run. Now, Quitta could use all the previous instructions to fully equip our ship before we arrive at Bucks. Let's make sure we really impress him.
Construction start.
Okay, so that's the first part sorted out. And we have landed!
Well done, Captain. We have arrived at the rendezvous. I hope you are ready to get down to real business now. Buckman is waiting for you. He will give you the terms of your first assignment. Click on the Missions button.
Good news, rookie space runner. I have a job for us. And by us, I mean mostly you. Have you heard of big cargo?
Yes, of course. My captain and I are familiar with them. They're the biggest mover of cargo in the known systems. Their headquarters orbit the ice.
Very good. Lucky for you, their CEO, Suzanne.
Nice to meet you, space runner. Buck speaks on.
My captain and I are eager to show you why that is.
Excellent. As it so happens, I do have a trial mission for you. It appears on one of his last runs, Buck forgot to deliver some goods to our headquarters.
Well, I admit, I do forget things from time to time. Not as young as I used to be. Plus, pirates trying to kill you makes you prioritize more important things. Like surviving.
In his defense, Mr. Buck has taken a lot of shots to the head. Sometimes it's a wonder he remembers anything at all.
Anyhow, I would greatly appreciate you delivering my leftover cargo from Buck's base to my HQ, orbiting Gaius.
Consider it done, ma'am.
You're bound to run into a pirate or two. Make sure to give him my regards before you blow him away. I'd say good luck, but luck is for chumps.
Let's see what you're made of.
Right.
The system map allows you to plan and choose your next flight. You can see all the interesting locations of this system. Links between locations are delivery highways we can use to transport cargo. Markers with a colored delivery arrow show where cargo of the same color must be delivered. Simple, isn't it? Our current mission is to transport BC's cargo from Buck Station to Gaius. Let's launch a flight to our destination. Click on the location with the destination mark, then click on the run button. Captain, we are ready to load cargo onto the ship. Click on a cargo icon in the lower dock section to select it. Then, click on an empty space on the ship to place it. So easy, even a human can do it. Load all cargo from the dock to your ship. Then click on the start button.
Okay.
Captain, I've activated the threat detection radar. If anything bad comes our way. Some asteroids have been detected and are heading towards us. I suggest...
And we are ready! Alright, so we have 6 asteroids incoming! Okay. So we got two guns facing downwards. Double the firepower. Nicely done. Right.
Interesting choice.
Good to go.
Ready to blast. surprise me. Speed is good.
Okay, yep. Very odd configuration. Right. We have rocks incoming. Have finished.
So good, they might even make a video game about us.
Oh, yes. Yep, so a few dozen guns, a couple of thrusters, and we managed to make it mostly safe and sound. Run time 5 minutes 34 seconds.
Congratulations, Rookie. I am very pleased by this delivery. I look forward to working together again very soon.
Level up. New elements unlocked. Okay. Extra rewards. Thank you.
I'm happy to report that your payment for the first delivery has been confirmed. You have earned some space credits, the universal money in the known universe. BC has also offered you some very special cargo, containing various crafting materials. These materials can be used by the mechanic to upgrade your ship. Click on the mechanic button.
Yeah.
Ah, another space.
Don't worry, we understand you don't.
Of course, you're gonna need.
My captain and I would not.
Our conglomerate operates in pretty much.
We will do our best.
Okay, right.
A wise choice. I always say, better to craft than to buy.
Okay.
A basic but sound choice.
So you can add to your ship. Right.
These may be useful. Doesn't crafting make you feel proud?
Yep, and we are done.
Spaceports are now accessible. If you wish to install new empty cells on your ship, as you progress.
Just a moment, please. Registration ID.
Great. Do we get a nifty membership card?
We administrate all officially registered.
My, that does seem handy.
You may find your ship a little cramped from time to time.
I'm sure, Mike.
Ship shape and ready to go.
As you progress as a space runner, you will be entrusted with more deliveries. Be sure to check the mission section anytime you visit a new spot to get new ones.
Yep, and I think we're going to leave this here. So, This is Blighty Otaku, signing off. Until next time, which for this should be in about a month, I'll catch you laters.